Swaminarayan. Good morning, all of you. I hope you all are well. So today, I am going to teach you Unit 5, Indigo. What is the meaning of indigo? Indigo is a commercial crop. It is one kind of crop. So let us discuss about author. Who is the author of this chapter? The author of this chapter is Louis Fisher, 1896 to 1917, was born in Philadelphia. He served as a volunteer in the British Army between 1918 and 1920. Fisher made a career as a journalist and wrote for the New York Times, the Saturday Review, and for European and Asian publications. He was also a member of the faculty at Princeton University. The following is an excerpt from his book, The Life of Mahatma Gandhi. The book has been revived as one of the best books ever written on Gandhi by Times Educational Supplement. So let us begin with this chapter. When I first visited Gandhi in 1942 at his ashram in Sevagram in central India, he said, "I will tell you how it happened that I decided to urge the departure of the British." It was in 1917. So when author when first time visited Gandhiji in 1942 in ashram in Sevagram. Sevagram is located in Maharashtra in central India. He said, "I'll tell you how it happened that I decided to urge the departure of the British." It was in 1917. When Gandhiji came to India in 1915, he has think it to departed the Britishers from the India in 1917. He had gone to the December 1916 annual convention of the Indian National Congress Party in Lucknow. There were 2,301 delegates and many visitors. When author first time gone in 1916 annual convention of the Indian National Congress Party in Lucknow, there were 2,301 delegates, means leaders, and there are also many visitors. During the proceeding, Gandhiji recounted, "A peasant came up to me looking like any other peasant in India, poor and emaciated." In that convention, Gandhiji said that any of peasants are poor and emaciated, means weak, and said, "I am Rajkumar Shukla, I am from Champaran, and I want you to come to my district." One of the peasants in that convention said that, "I am Rajkumar Shukla and he is from Champaran, and he want that Gandhiji to come in his district." Gandhiji had never heard of the place. It was in the foothills of the towering Himalayas near the kingdom of Nepal. So Gandhiji think that he had never heard this type of name of that district. So Gandhiji just think that the village is located in the foothills of the towering Himalayas near the kingdom of Nepal. Under an ancient arrangement, the Champaran peasants were sharecroppers. So here in this ancient arrangement, the peasant of the Champaran are sharecroppers. So what is the meaning of sharecropper? It means work under a system called sharecropping, in which a landowner allowed tenants to use their land and return share of produce, portion of land. So these peasants basically worked as tenants in huge land of the landlords. Rajkumar Shukla was one of them, and Rajkumar Shukla is also sharecropper. He was illiterate but resolute. He had come to the Congress session to complain about the injustice of the landlord system in Bihar, and somebody had probably said, "Speak to Gandhiji." He just raised his voice about the injustice done by the Britishers, done by the landlords to them. And somebody in that session, Congress session, said to him that, "Speak to Gandhiji, go to the Gandhiji. Gandhi told Shukla that he had an appointment in Kanpur and was also committed to go to other parts of India. So when Gandhiji met Shukla ji, then he told him that he had appointment in Kanpur. Kanpur is the old name of Kanpur. And he also had committed to go to the other parts of India. Shukla accompanied him everywhere. Then Gandhiji returned to his ashram near Ahmedabad. Shukla followed him to the ashram. For weeks, he never left Gandhiji's side. So Shukla waited for Gandhiji. Every time, he accompanied him from Kanpur to his ashram for a week. And he wanted him to give an appointment to visit Champaran. Fix a date, he begged. Shukla tells Gandhiji that please fix an appointment to visit Champaran. Impressed by the sharecropper's tenacity and story, Gandhi said, I have to be in Calcutta on such and such a date. Come and meet me and take me from there. So Gandhiji was very impressed by this sharecropper's tenacity and story. So Gandhiji told them that come and meet me and then I am coming to your Month passed. Shukla was sitting on his haunches at the appointed spot in Calcutta. When Gandhi arrived, he waited till Gandhi was free. Months are passing, but Shukla ji was sitting on his haunches. Haunches means folding with his leg. And the appointed spot in Calcutta. When Gandhi ji arrived, he waited till Gandhi was free. So he was waited for Gandhi ji. Eagerly, two of them boarded the train for the city of Patna in Bihar. There, Shukla led him to the house of the lawyer named Rajendra Prasad. Then, Shukla and Gandhi ji both have took the train to the Bihar, and Shukla led Gandhi ji to the prominent lawyer named Rajendra Prasad, who later became the president of the Congress Party and of India. So, Rajendra Prasad is the first president of Free India. Rajendra Prasad was out of town. He was not there. But the servants knew Shukla as a poor yeoman who pestered their master to help the indigo sharecroppers. But the servant of Rajendra Prasad, Shukla, as poor yeoman means farmer who pestered their master to help the indigo sharecroppers. Shukla bar bar unke master ko pareshan karne ke liye aa jate the. So they let him stay on the grounds with his companion. So servants tell them to let them stay on the ground with his companion, with Gandhiji, whom they took to be another peasant. They just think that Gandhiji was also peasant. But Gandhi was not permitted to draw water from the well, lest some drops from his bucket pollute the entire source. How did they know that he was not an untouchable? Gandhiji is not permitted to take a drop of water from the bucket because they think that if they put their hand in the bucket, it is polluted at the entire source. So, they think that they are untouchables. How did they know that he was not an untouchable? How did they know that Gandhiji was not an untouchable? Gandhi decided to go first to Muzaffarpur, which was en route to Champaran, to obtain more complete information about condition than Shukla was capable of imparting. So, he doesn't meet Rajendra Prasad. So, they are decided to go Muzaffarpur, which is en route to Champaran, jo raste mein hi aata tha, Champaran ke raste mein hi aata tha, to obtain more complete information about the condition than Shukla was capable of imparting. He accordingly sent a telegram to Professor J.B. Kriplani of the Arts College in Muzaffarpur. So that time they are very feared with that Britishers. So in those days, Indians were afraid of the Britishers and they did not provide the shelter those days who were involved in the freedom struggle. So, Gandhiji had already sent a letter to a professor, Jibi Kriplani, of the Arts College in Muzaffarpur, whom he had seen at Tagore Shantiniketan School. He had seen him first in Tagore Shantiniketan School. The train arrived in midnight, at midnight 15th April 1970. Kriplani was waiting at the station with a large body of students. Gandhiji stayed there for 2 days in the home of Professor Malkani, a teacher in a government school. So Gandhiji reached there and many large number of students welcomed him at station, and Gandhiji stayed there 2 to 3 days at Professor Malkani's home. Professor Malkani is a government teacher. It was an extraordinary thing in those days, Gandhi commented, for a government professor to harbor a man like me. So Gandhiji just says him that it is an extraordinary thing, in those days, that one government professor teacher give me shelter. In smaller localities, the Indians were afraid to show sympathy for advocates at home rule. In smaller localities, smaller area, rural area, the Indians were afraid to show sympathy for advocates. Advocates means freedom fighter of home rule. Of Gandhi's advent and of the nature of his mission spread quickly through Muzaffarpur and to Champaran. Gandhiji come to our district. This news is reached everywhere that his mission spread quickly through Muzaffarpur and Champaran. The news of Gandhi's advent and of the nature of his mission spread quickly through Muzaffarpur and to Champaran. So Gandhiji came to our district. This news is spread everywhere in Muzaffarpur and Champaran also. Sharecroppers from Champaran began arriving on foot and by convenience to see their champion. Sharecroppers from Champaran are coming through foot or convenience means of transport, by transport, to see their champion. Here the meaning of champion means it indicates a person fighting for right for them. Muzaffarpur lawyers called on Gandhiji to brief him. They frequently represented peasant group in court. They told him about their cases and reported the size of their fee. Muzaffarpur lawyers tells Gandhiji everything briefly, and they frequently represent peasant group in court. They also told Gandhiji about their cases and the size of their fees. Gandhi shielded the lawyers for collecting big fee from the sharecroppers. He said, I have come to the conclusion that we should stop going to low courts. Taking such cases to the courts does little good, where the peasants are so crushed and fear-stricken. Low courts are useless. The real relief for them is to be free from fear. Gandhiji scolded the lawyers for collecting a huge amount of fees from the sharecroppers. He also said that he had concluded that they should stop to going to the low courts because such cases to the court does little good, where the peasants are so crushed and fear-stricken. Low courts are useless for that type of peasant. The real relief for them is to be free from fear to the Britishers and landowners. Most of the arable land in the Champaran district was divided into large estates owned by Englishmen and worked by Indian tenants. Most of the arable capable land in the Champaran district was divided into large estates owned by Englishmen and landlords and rent farmers. The chief commercial crop was indigo. Indigo is a very commercial crop that time. The landlords compelled all tenants to plant 3/20 or 15% of their holdings with indigo and surrendered the entire indigo harvest as rent. This was done by long-term contract. They have planned to give 15% of landlord's holding with Indigo and surrendered the rent farmers to harvest as rent. So this was done by long-term contract with between rent farmers and the Englishmen, the landlords. Presently, the landlords learned that Germany had developed synthetic indigo. Synthetic indigo means artificial indigo. Germany has produced it. They thereupon obtained agreement from the sharecroppers to pay them compensation for being released from the 15% arrangement. Then they want retribution for being released from the 15% of agreement between them. The sharecropping arrangement was irksome to the peasant. It is very troublesome to the peasants. And many signed willingly. Those who resisted engaged lawyers. The landlords hired thugs. Those who are very poor, they have signed willingly. And those who are resisted, who are opposed to that agreement, engaged lawyers. And the landlords hired thugs. The landlords wants to take. Synthetic indigo had been produced in Germany, no longer needed the indigo that was produced in India. So they wanted to end this sharecropping arrangement. Some of the peasants are agreed to it, while some of them are resisted, forced to agree by power or by threat. So while they know about synthetic indigo was reproduced in Germany, and this was the reason why their sharecropping agreement is nullified. They did not want to give compensation to the owners, and hence they wanted their money back. At this point, Gandhi arrived in Champaran. Due to this type of issues, Gandhi arrived in Champaran. Now, he began by trying to get the facts. First, he visited the secretary of the British Landlords Association. The secretary told him that they could give no information to an outsider. Gandhi answered that he was no outsider. Then Gandhiji tried to get some information about it. So first of all, he visited the secretary of the British Landlords Association. Then the secretary answered him that he could not give information to the outsider, to the stranger. But Gandhiji answered that I am not a stranger, I am not the outsider. Next, Gandhiji called on the British official commissioner of the Tirhut division in which the Champaran district lay. Next day, Gandhiji was reached at British official commissioner of the Tirhut division. Tirhut division is a bigger place in which Champaran district lay. The commissioner, Gandhi reports, proceeded to bully me and advised me forthwith to leave Tirhut. Then Gandhiji reports that the commissioner sent him to miscreant him and advised him that leave Tirhut immediately. Gandhi did not leave. Gandhi did not leave that district. Instead, he proceeded to Motihari, the capital of Champaran. Motihari is the capital of Champaran. Several lawyers accompanied him. Several lawyers greeted him. At the railway station, a vast multitude greeted Gandhiji. When Gandhiji reached at the railway station of Motihari, a vast multitude greeted Gandhiji. A vast crowd of many people greeted him or welcomed him at railway station. He went to the house and using it as headquarters, continued his investigation. Gandhiji reached there and went at one house and using it as headquarters and continued with his investigation. A report came in that a peasant had been maltreated in a nearby village. Gandhiji has got an information that the nearby village peasants were tortured by landlords. Gandhi decided to go and see the next morning. He started out on the back of an elephant. So Gandhiji decided that I should go there and see what happened. And he had not proceeded far when the police superintendent's messenger messenger overtook him and ordered him to return to town in his carriage. He was started to visit that place, but at the middle of the way, the superintendent messenger was met him and ordered him to return town with his luggage. Gandhi complied. Gandhiji had said no. The messenger drove Gandhi home, where he served him with an official notice to quit Champaran immediately. The messenger drove Gandhiji home and then gave him a notice, an official notice, that you should leave Champaran immediately. Gandhi signed a receipt for the notice and wrote on it that he would disobey the order. Gandhiji signed that notice and then wrote below that he would disobey. He would not obey this order. Thank you. Tomorrow we will continue with the another part of this chapter.